Hello everyone, thanks for tuning into this video. In this video, let us see solar cell parameters. So, the main important parameters of solar cell for analyzing its performance are short circuit current ISC and open circuit voltage represented by VOC and current IM and voltage VM. These correspond to maximum power points and at last fill factor. So these are the five solar cell parameters we have to analyze the circuit. And here we can see two circuits, equivalent circuits of solar cell in open circuit condition as well as short circuit condition. So here in open circuit condition, we open the terminals, so the current I would be zero. And so here, so this is we are doing to calculate the value of, so by using equivalent circuit we are calculating open circuit voltage, and here by using the equivalent circuit in short circuit condition we are finding the short circuit current ISC, that is the current that is flowing here. And so here the ISC short circuit current, it depends on cell technology, like whether crystalline silicon or polycrystalline silicon or thin film solars based on direct band gap semiconductors like cadmium telluride, copper indium, gallium selenide, sulfide, gallium arsenic, and also organic solar cells. And next, ISC also depends on the solar cell area. So as area increases, the amount of solar radiation the cell is receiving, that would increase. So likewise, short circuit current will increase. And next is the amount of solar radiation falling on the cell. So the solar radiation is not fixed, it changes with time. So based on that variation, ISC also varies. And next is the angle of inclination of solar cell. So with respect to time, the angle with which the solar radiation is falling on the cell is changing. So when it is directly falling on the cell, then there would be maximum ISC, but as the inclination increases, the magnitude of ISC will decrease. So this is how these four things are related to ISC. And next is VOC. Here open circuit voltage, this also depends on cell technology like crystalline silicon or polycrystalline silicon or thin film solar cells. And also it depends on cell temperature or module temperature. So temperature also will affect the open circuit voltage, and how this affects we will see in further. So here in open circuit condition, I is zero. So this is a open circuit case where I is zero because these terminals are open, and now the voltage across diode is VOC. So here this is the voltage at these two terminals is VOC, and as the current is zero, there is no drop in this series resistor. So the same VOC is across RSH and across diode, as these are connected in parallel. So that's, and therefore, the diode current ID is equal to I naught into e power diode voltage by eta Vt minus 1, but diode voltage is VOC, so that we substituted. And so now we are calculating here e to the power VOC by eta Vt minus 1 is equal to ID by I naught. Then VOC by eta Vt is equal to ln. If we take the exponential this side, it gets ln. So in this way we simplify VOC. Once we get VOC, this is the case here. And so here ID diode current is equal to IL. So in this, RSH is very large, so only very little current, very minute current will flow, which is, we can approximate it as zero, and this is open, so ID is equal to IL, and that's why we get, we can substitute in place of ID, IL. So open circuit voltage will be eta Vt ln into IL by I naught plus 1. And now here VT thermal voltage, which we have seen in the previous lecture, which is KT by Q. Now substituting that VT in the VOC, we end up getting this equation. So now here we see that VOC is a function of temperature here and I naught. So how does temperature affects the VOC? So VOC can be approximated to this. So here it is plus 1 is there, but even if we remove this plus 1, we can approximate for the sake of analysis. It doesn't make much difference. So for every 10 Kelvin rise, that is for every 10 degree Celsius rise or 10 Kelvin rise in temperature, I naught will get double. So IL increases slightly with temperature. As it increases slightly, we may assume that IL is constant. Now eta, K and Q are also constant. So here K is Boltzmann constant, which is constant. Q is charge of electron, which is constant, and eta is constant for the material. So VOC is directly proportional to temperature, ln into 1 by I naught. So let us assume two temperatures, 300 Kelvin and 320 Kelvin. So let's VOC 1 is related to 300 Kelvin and VOC 2 is related to 320 Kelvin. So when we take this ratio, this is from the previous, this is T. So 300 by 320 ln, and for every 10 degrees Celsius, I naught will get doubled. But here, for every 10 kilo Kelvin rise, I naught will double. So for 20 Kelvin, it will become 4 times. So here, 4 times I naught as ln 1 by I naught. So which is like inversely proportional to logarithmic. Hence, we get here 4 I naught by I naught, which is equal to 15 by 16 into ln 4. And so VOC 2 will be VOC 1 by 1.3, which is 0.769 VOC 1. So VOC decreases as the temperature increases. So here you may see that it is directly proportional to temperature, ln 1 by I naught. But I naught is more dominant than temperature T. So with increase in temperature, VOCs get reduced because I naught is more dominant. Next is the short circuit current. We have ISC. So to calculate short circuit current, we can see here short circuit equivalent circuit. So here we have to calculate ISC. Now here ISC and IR both equal, that is I is equal to ISC. So here from this we can see that ISC is nothing but when we apply KCL here, IL minus ID minus ISH is equal to ISC. So IL minus ID minus ISH. But we know that ID is equal to I naught. So here in this case, diode voltage in short circuit case, what is the diode voltage? So here RS is very little. So RS value is series resistance value is very little. So ISC times of RSC also will be little. So the voltage across diode we can assume as zero. Hence this voltage is zero. We get the diode current is zero and ISH is also negligible. So here it is not exactly zero, but similarly approximately zero, close to zero, this ID value and ISH is also similar. So ISH can be equal to IL. Now, so for analysis sake, you may substitute here in place of IL, you may substitute ISC. So now here next parameter we are going to use is fill factor. Now fill factor is a figure of merit for the PV cell. That is, it is used to determine how good or bad a PV cell is. That is, it determines the quality of solar cell. Now here it is calculated by comparing the maximum power that we can extract to the theoretical power that would be output at both the open circuit voltage and short circuit current together. And so here this red line represents VI IV characteristics of solar cell. Here ISC, that is when it is short circuited, and VOC when it is open circuited. So here this represents the, when we take a rectangle with the breadth ISC and length VOC, we get this area, and this IMP and VMP correspond to maximum power voltage and maximum power current, and we have another green area. So fill factor is nothing but ratio of green area by blue area. So when here, as it is indicated, blue area is nothing but the whole outer rectangle, and so this will give the fill factor. So when it is close to one, it is good, it is ideal, that is their ratios must be close to one. And from this IMP into VMP will give power at maximum power point, which is nothing but fill factor into, so fill factor FF into IS into VOC. So PMP is the maximum power that the solar cell can deliver. And now the efficiency of solar cell, which is equal to maximum power that solar cell can deliver to load by power incident on solar cell. So it is VMP into IMP by PI, that is fill factor into VOC into ISC by PI. So for getting a high efficiency solar cell, it is important to have a high fill factor, high VOC and high ISC. So these three are very important aspects in this regard. And we know that PI is the incident power, which would be like 1000 watt per meter square. So with this we have seen the solar cell parameters which help us to analyze the solar cell performance. And so thank you for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one.